frightening reminder that you never really know who you're meeting for the first time on the internet.
Right, a man trying to just buy a car, a used car in North Fairmount, beaten up and robbed by two men he met on Craigslist. And News Host Kristina Cruise is live tonight to tell us what you need to know to protect yourself. Kristina?
Well, Jack and Cherie, the main thing to know is that this can happen to you. This victim took precautions. He met in broad daylight in a residential neighborhood, but it just wasn't enough.
Never. Would never even touch it.
Perry Angela Arsoul is talking about Kenneth Stover. He came to Arsoul's North Fairmont neighborhood to buy a used car he found on Craigslist. Instead, he wound up whacked in the head and robbed.
I feel so sorry for him.
According to Cincinnati police, Stover met up with two men on Denham Avenue. Stover had $500 cash to buy the car. Instead, he walked right into a ripoff.
We don't see much at all. The last time we heard of anything similar to this was in Dayton about 5 months ago.
But Fran says you should still take steps to protect yourself. First, know the turf. Never meet in an unfamiliar neighborhood. His advice?
In front of a police station is a perfect place to meet.
He adds, don't carry cash. Instead, take a certified check or money order and bring some backup. Have a buddy stay in the car watching, cell phone in hand to call for help if necessary.
Yeah, it's like anything else in society. It has its benefits, and a wise user can use it and not get in any trouble.
Now, the bottom line is be skeptical. Think about your safety first and worry about getting a good deal later, Jack.
Kristina, I know you got some other specific suggestions. What are those?
Well, a couple of things you could do. First, you're going to want to talk with the sellers on the phone, not just through a couple quick emails. Preferably, you want to get a landline. That way you know it's a legitimate number. Do what you can to confirm that. Let a friend or family member know exactly where you are going. And, of course, always trust your instincts, Jack.
Kristina, thanks so much.
Well, listen to this. Another Craigslist scam to warn you about here, too. People preying on people in need of jobs and cheap housing.
Now, that's a lot of people.
Right. This is a company called YLD. The Better Business Bureau gives the company an F rating. YLD listed ads on Craigslist for low-cost apartments in high-paying jobs. But you had to register for a credit check with keycreditreport.com. Also F-rated by the Better Business Bureau. Many people got hit with a fee of $85 a month.
It is a lot of money. Well, they're looking to target people. Obviously, jobs are a major consideration right now. A lot of people are out of work. So you had a whole audience that was applying because they desperately needed a job. If they needed a job, then they didn't have $85 a month to spend frivolously.
Here's the worst part, though. There were no jobs and no apartments. Both companies have been taken offline, but the Better Business Bureau warns they'll likely pop up again.